Good afternoon, everyone. Today we are going to a study regarding vital force and its concept in homeopathic philosophy. एक चीज आप लोग को पहले बता दे, स्क्रीन पे ना कोई और राइट मत करना जब हम स्क्रीन शो करेंगे, ठीक है? चलो, सो बिफोर वी डिस्कस इन डिटेल्स रिगार्डिंग दिस वाइटल फोर्स, फर्स्ट लेट मी टेल यू दैट दिस कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ वाइटल फोर्स इज वन ऑफ द पार्ट ऑफ योर कार्डिनल प्रिंसिपल दैट वी हैव स्टडीड अर्लियर. बट दिस पार्ट दैट इज एफरिज्म नंबर 9-18 इज वन ऑफ द वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एंड मोस्ट वाइटल सेक्शन ऑफ होम्योपैथिक फिलोसफी. Understanding of this vital force, the concept of vital force is very important because whatever you have studied till aphorism number 1-7 is also become clear, and you will understand it more better when you will understand this section of aphorism number 9-18 regarding the vital force, as well as all the rest of the part of homeopathic philosophy that we are going to study in Organon of Medicine can only be understood clearly if you have a clear concept of the concept of this vital force. So this section is one of the most important section if you want to understand the homeopathic philosophy. One thing I would also like to say that this part, the homeopathic philosophy of vital force, is one of the reason why homeopathy is different not only from allopathic concept of medicine but also within this Ayush system. Whatever the system of medicines they are included in Ayush, this concept of vital force and its philosophy, its inclusion in homeopathy, is also separating them from the different other systems in Ayush also. And this section is responsible for the uniqueness of homeopathy in all the medical field, in all the medical practices till now we are going to practice, till now we know about them. One more thing, this is the concept, because of this, whatever controversies nowadays that you are reading, hearing about homeopathy, that medicine has nothing, it is just only water, it is just acting as a placebo and blah blah regarding this homeopathic philosophy, is also because of those people. They are not understanding this section of homeopathic philosophy. Because this section is not just regarding vital force, this is having another hidden motive that is called the concept of dynamism. And that concept of dynamism and materialism is the real difference between all the other system of medicine and homeopathy. Because it is homeopathy and homeopathy alone that uses this potentized, dynamized form of every medicinal substance. Rest all other systems either using medicines or they are using other systems of treatment, but they are not using dynamized medicine. And this use of dynamized medicine is the factor when till now our scientific fraternity is not able to diagnose or identify the medicinal content, and so they blame homeopathic medicine as placebo. So this is the importance of this section of vital force, this section of the concept of this. So let's, with this short introduction, let's start this concept of vital force. एक और चीज बताना चाहेंगे बिफोर वी स्टडी दिस वाइटल फोर्स. जस्ट थिंक एवरीवन, जस्ट फॉर 30 सेकेंड यू थिंक अबाउट समवन who is living and someone who is dead. What is the difference between these two? If one is alive and one is dead, what part is missing in him? कभी देखा है कोई organ गायब है क्या? अगर normal कोई accidental death नहीं है, कोई traumatic death नहीं है तो whether any part is gone, whether nose, ear, lips, etc., etc. is gone, everything physically is available. Everything is available. Then what is missing? Can you identify those, the missing part? Can you hold on that missing part? We can only perceive the expression of that presence and its absence. The presence of that force, the presence of that principle make one individual living organism, and the absence of that particular principle make one individual dead. But we cannot see, we cannot touch, we cannot hold on that part. And that is the part that we are going to study, that is called vital force. That is for our understanding superficially, before we go to the details of homeopathic philosophy, that a difference between a living organism and a dead individual, and that difference now we are going to study, what is that thing, what is that principle, that is what force, that the presence of that makes one individual alive and absence makes one individual dead. Let me share my screen. So with this short introduction, we are now going to study homeopathic concept and its utilization of vital force. First, we will study in this section of vital force these aphorisms, that is aphorism number 9 to aphorism number 18. And these are the shortest message. You can note it down, or I will upload these informations to my website. These are the shortest information, that is one line information about the following aphorisms that we are going to study, in which you will study aphorism number 9, describe role of vital force in health and the functions of vital force in health, as well as you can identify the concept of vital force in health. Aphorism number 10, material organism without vital force. That means if the vital force is absent, then what will be the condition of this material organism? This comes sharir kehte, that is called death. 11 is the role of vital force in disease state. And in this aphorism, you will study the definition of disease. Aapko jab ye aphorism batayenge to batayenge definition of disease, and that you must remember it, you must understand it for your exam purpose, either in theory or viva, or as well as for your consideration of concept of disease in homeopathy in details. And so this aphorism 11 has a different aspect, that is also you can say role of vital force in disease. Mostly this aphorism 9 to 18 is divided into three parts. One is called vital force in health, another is called vital force in disease, and the last part is called vital force in cure. And this is also one of the form of question that you will face in your theory exam regarding describe the role of vital force in health, describe the role of vital force in disease or in cure, and that you have to describe these answer from these sections of aphorisms. So next is aphorism number 12, diseases due to internal derangement of vital force. That means basically we will study in this aphorism that vital force is a dynamic force is not material, it is immaterial. And so vital force can be influenced by only dynamic force, either to make it sick or either from sickness to cure. In both the condition, we need dynamic force. That force that make it sick is called dynamic, morbific, natural agent. The force that make it from sickness to cure is called morbific dynamic agent. That is another name of artificial morbific dynamic agent. When we replace the word natural to artificial, then it becomes medicine. When we use the word natural morbific agent, then it becomes regarding the causative factor of disease like miasm, etc. Next, aphorism number 13, in which this aphorism is actually Hahnemann has mentioned the concept of orthodox concept of a school, not Hahnemann's concept. He has here mentioned this concept as the other people, the other brethren of medical fraternity, what think about this health and disease. And so it is called as materialism in medicine, because this deals with material concept, not dynamic concept. Then aphorism number 14, disease manifestation. This is one short aphorism regarding if anything else is hidden in the body. Nature has made this organism in such a compact way that nothing unwanted can remain in it without getting manifestation outside. Aphorism number 15, concept of holism. This is one of the, again, very important aphorism of this section, where we will concept, abhi hum aapko padha rahe na, vital force alag, organism alag. But in this aphorism, we will study that vital force and organism are not separate. Rather, we are studying it separate for its understanding. Actually, it is one, and that one is called life. So the basic concept is either life, that means living organism, or dead organism. Nothing else is divisible between them. Details mein padhenge jab usko padhenge. Then removal of, this is the vital force in cure. Removal of dynamic cause by dynamic medicine. Aphorism number 16, aphorism number 17 and 18. Okay. These are the three aphorisms that deals with the role of vital force in cure. Till now, you are getting me? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay. So, let's start. This is aphorism number 9. जिसके पास टेक्स्टबुक नहीं है, बिकॉज अभी आप लोग बहुत सारे लॉकडाउन में हो, सो आई एम गिविंग यू हेयर बोथ टेक्स्ट मैटर एज वेल एज माई टीचिंग ऑफ ब्रेकअप्स एंड एटसेट्रा. जो ब्रेकअप पार्ट हमने लिखा हुआ है, इस हर एफरिज्म में दिखाएंगे, जैसे ये वाला पार्ट है, इसको नोट कर लेना, फोटो ले लेना, या फिर बाद में वेबसाइट से नोट कर लेना, बिकॉज यू हैव टू प्रिपेयर वन स्मॉल ब्रेकअप फाइल फॉर योर ऑर्गेनन एग्जाम. और उसके लिए ये इस तरह का सेक्शन हर एफरिज्म में हम आपको देंगे, वो आपको लगेगा. ये खुद से भी बनाना होता है, बट दो सेक्शन विच आई टॉट आई विल गिव यू. सो दिस इज एफरिज्म नंबर 9 दैट वी कॉल वाइटल फोर्स इन हेल्थ. बट दिस एफरिज्म सेज इन द हेल्दी कंडीशन ऑफ मैन. बिफोर गोइंग टू द डिटेल, जस्ट सी this health I have given you in a multi-dimensional way. I have highlighted it in a multi-dimensional way. Because whenever in further aphorisms and in details, whenever we are going to study the concept of health in homeopathy, health is, or health must be understood in a multi-dimensional way. Health is not a part to study in one dimension. Just in short, remember the WHO definition of health. What it says, health is not merely the absence of disease, rather it is a state of complete well-being of mental, social and psychological well-being. Similarly, in homeopathic concept, this also applies. Absence of disease is not just a complete concept of health. आपको aphorism number 8 हमने पढ़ाया है, वहाँ आपको बताया होगा कि it is not just the absence of symptom, rather it is the a perfect way of coordination with your society, with your nation, with your own self. Now this reflects health. When you will case taking, do and everything, this short thing about health, I will just going to describe you that we must consider one individual in at least 4 dimension. One is called physical dimension. Another is called intellectual dimension. Next is called emotional dimension. And the fourth one is called spiritual dimension. जब कभी केस टेकिंग पढ़ाएंगे तो इसको हम आपको डिस्क्राइब करेंगे. दैट मीन्स दिस ऑल कंबाइंड टूगेदर रिफ्लेक्ट्स इन द स्टेट ऑफ हेल्थ. इसमें से किसी भी एक डायमेंशन में अगर डिस्टर्बेंस हो, मोस्टली वी नो ओनली द फिजिकल डायमेंशन व्हेन समवन इज कमिंग और समवन इज डिस्क्राइबिंग दोज हु आर इग्नोरिंग अबाउट देयर हेल्थ. ओनली द डिस्टर्बेंस ऑफ फिजिकल डायमेंशन दे कॉल इट इनटू अ स्टेट ऑफ हेल्थ, बट इट इज नॉट सो. We must have to find in every dimension. So it is not a matter to describe in details here. When we will describe case taking or health, then we will describe it. So in aphorism number 9, what Hanuman says, in the healthy condition of man, the spiritual vital force. Ye words sabko hum likhayenge ki screen pe not koi bhi mark mat karo. What are the other adjectives Hanuman has used regarding this vital force? Ye aapko aayega exam mein bhi, the properties of vital force and adjectives of vital force. So one adjective that Hanuman has used regarding this vital force is the spiritual. So let's summarize me this aphorism in short. The spiritual vital force, the autocracy, the dynamis that animates the material organism. So pehla message yahan pe Hanuman kya de raha hai, ye jo dynamic spiritual vital force है वो क्या करता है, इट एनिमेट्स द मटेरियल ऑर्गेनिज्म. ये एनिमेट्स का मतलब होता है गिविंग लाइफ, किसी चीज को जीवन देना, किसी चीज को इनलाइवन करना. दैट मीन्स विदाउट दिस वाइटल फोर्स, शरीर एक सिर्फ ढांचा था, एक डेड स्ट्रक्चर था, या जो भी कंसेप्ट कह लो. Vital force का प्रेजेंस, इसको लाइफ की सारी एक्टिविटीज जो ये कर रहा है, दैट इज ओनली बिकॉज ऑफ दिस वाइटल फोर्स. सो वाइटल फोर्स क्या कर रहा है, वाइटल फोर्स एनिमेट्स द मटेरियल ऑर्गेनिज्म. दिस इज वन फंक्शन ऑफ वाइटल फोर्स. अनदर कह रहा है रूल्स विथ अनबाउंडेड स्वे. ये किसके बारे में है, दिस इज रिगार्डिंग वाइटल फोर्स. ये वाइटल फोर्स के एक नेचर को बता रहा है, रूल्स विथ अनबाउंडेड स्वे. अनबाउंडेड स्वे का मतलब क्या है पता है? ये वर्ड स्वे यूज होता है एक पेंडुलस मूवमेंट के लिए भी, बट यहां पे ये पेंडुलम के मूवमेंट के लिए नहीं है. अनदर मीनिंग ऑफ वर्ड स्वे इज कॉल्ड रूल, गवर्न, शासन करना. दैट मीन्स वाइटल फोर्स जो एक्शन करता है, जो शासन करता है, ये किसी के बाउंडेशन में नहीं है, ये किसी के प्रेशर में नहीं है, किसी के इन्फ्लुएंस में नहीं है, ये अपने आप में है. दैट इज सेल्फ गवर्न्ड, दैट इज कॉल्ड अनबाउंडेड स्वे. इट इज नॉट गाइडेड बाय समवन एल्स, इट इज नॉट गाइडेड बाय सम अदर फोर्स, इट इज इंडिपेंडेंट इन इटसेल्फ. दैट्स व्हाई द वर्ड ऑटोक्रेसी इज ऑल्सो सेड अबाउट दिस. ऑटो मीन्स सेल्फ, क्रेसी मीन्स गवर्न्ड, रूल्ड, सेल्फ गवर्न्ड, सेल्फ रूल्ड, अपने आप से चलने वाला, अपने आप के अकॉर्डिंग करने वाला, नॉट गाइडेड बाय समथिंग एल्स. सो ये कह रहा है वाइटल फोर्स के बारे में. देन एंड रिटेन ऑल पार्ट्स ऑफ द ऑर्गेनिज्म इन एडमायरेबल हार्मोनियस वाइटल ऑपरेशन. सो वाइटल फोर्स क्या कर रहा है, पहला काम ये दिखना, द फंक्शन ऑफ वाइटल फोर्स. फर्स्ट इज it gives life to the material body. Because it gives life to the material body, it is responsible for all this admirable, harmonious, vital operation. This is called the manifestation of perfect health, that we call admirable, harmonious, vital operation. As regard both in sensation and function. That means our organism, if this material body is functioning in admirable, harmonious, vital operation, then how we will perceive it? Hanuman says it is not a matter of things to look inside. Rather, it will, if it is functioning in this three adjectives way, that is admirable, harmonious, vital operation, then it will be manifested to you through your senses, through sensations and functions. The organism's sensation and functions describes its functioning, whether it is functioning in a healthy, harmonious way or whether it is working in a disturbed and diseased way. Next is called, agar vital force ne organism ko aliven kiya, animate kiya, then organism is working in a harmonious or vital operation. Then the most important third section of this aphorism is, so that the indwelling reason gifted mind, ye indwelling kiske liye keh raha hai? Mind. Isko agar abhi aur higher class mein aoge to aur aapko details mein batayenge, when we have a concept of Cartesian and concept of dualism and holism. So here Hanuman says this mind is nothing but a section of your own organism. That's why it is called indwelling. Indwelling ka matlab hota hai koi cheez usi mein jo rehta ho. Something that is a part of that. That's why it is called indwelling. So indwelling is nothing but, while your mind is nothing but the part of your constitution. So indwelling reason gifted mind can freely employ this living healthy instrument. Ye living healthy instrument use kar raha hai for a living organism. जो कि वाइटल फोर्स की वजह से जिंदा हो गया, जो कि वाइटल फोर्स की वजह से एक लिविंग ऑर्गेनिज्म की तरह बिहेव कर रहा है. सो व्हाट माइंड टेक्स यूज ऑफ दैट माइंड, रीजन गिफ्टेड माइंड कैन फ्रीली एम्प्लॉय दिस लिविंग हेल्दी ऑर्गेनिज्म फॉर द हायर पर्पस ऑफ एग्जिस्टेंस. हायर पर्पस ऑफ एग्जिस्टेंस, इफ वी गो इन टू द फिलोसफी, the higher purpose of an individual may be different. Person X may have something different higher purpose in their life. Person Y may have different higher purpose in life, and so on. But actually, what is the higher purpose of life? If we say life, then life has no other higher purpose than continuity of life in a perfect state of health itself. So jeevan prakriya healthy way mein progressively persistent rahe is duniya pe, that is the utility of that is the one of the higher purpose of life. It is higher purpose of life, I am saying, not higher purpose of any individual. Once again, an individual may have different higher purpose, but as if life is concerned, life has its greatest higher purpose as the continuity of life in its healthy way. And this healthy way, when we say that, doesn't mean only to beget life. It is related to your all accessory phenomena. That means keeping all the natural thing in a healthy way. And if we progress along with the force of nature, with keeping every our accessory circumstances in a healthy way, this is called the way of higher purpose of existence. So, in short, I'm not giving you in more details because you are just in second BHMS, because these aphorisms may be studied for weeks for your in advanced or PG classes. If you have doubt, then you will ask me further. So this is the breakup that you have to note down in your breakup file, and in which that just see what I have given you, vital force. These are called the characters of vital force that summarize separately. This is vital force. These are the characters of vital force that is called spiritual. I will describe each words in details afterwards if time permits, then today, otherwise tomorrow or day after tomorrow. So the natures of vital force or character of vital force is what? These are the characters of vital force. One is called spiritual, autocracy, dynamis, automatic, or immaterial. When writing this vital force, characters of vital force, one more character you can add. I have not given it here because it is not the part of aphorism number 9. And that character of vital force is called vital force is unintelligent. And that word you will find in aphorism number 22 footnote. That is unintelligent vital force. And by adding this unintelligent, this characters of vital force will be completed. So, vital force, these are the character of vital force. This is called vital force. Kya karta hai? It animates material organism. I have just tried to given you here in a diagrammatic way to understand the aphorism number 9. So vital force, what it does? It animates kisko? Material organism. Animates hota hai, toh kya karta hai? It shows admirable, harmonious, vital operation. This is one section. Jab ye admirable, vital, harmonious operations mein aa jata hai, then what happens? Then this automatically present, indwelling, reason gifted mind utilizes this. This what Hahnemann has said at the healthy instrument. This utilizes the reason gifted mind for the purpose of higher purpose of our existence. Am I clear till here?
Yes, sir.
Okay. I think 5 minutes aur bacha hai. Thora sa describe kar lete hain. This is spiritual. Spiritual word ka matlab aap ye jo abhi hum dharmik samajhte hain na, ye dharmik nahi hai. This is not related to religious concept of when we say spiritual. Spiritual matlab hota hai yahan pe. Hahnemann has given here the word spiritual. Spiritual means something that is immaterial, something that is very a type of volatile in nature, something that is having an ethereal nature. That means wo ya to hai ya nahi hai. We cannot hold on it. आपने केमिस्ट्री में पढ़ा होगा स्पिरिट लैम्प. स्पिरिट लैम्प का मतलब नहीं होता है कि वो धार्मिक और स्पिरिचुअल है. वो जो स्पिरिट वर्ड यूज किया गया है, दैट स्पिरिट इज फॉर इट्स कैरेक्टर ऑफ इथरल. इथरल का मतलब होता है बीइंग वोलेटाइल. दैट मींस इट इज हाईली वोलेटाइल. इट इज जस्ट प्रेजेंट और अगर सुटेबल एनवायरमेंट नहीं है देन इट विल डिसअपीयर इन द एनवायरमेंट. कहां गया? यू कैन नॉट आइडेंटिफाई, यू कैन नॉट डॉट इट. So that is one of the character of vital force. Jinda hai to hai, mar gaya kya aap dekhte ho vital force ko nikalte hue wo animated TV serial ke baad chhod do, otherwise ki ye naak se aise nikal raha hai, ye yahan se nikal raha hai. You cannot see it, you cannot hold it, you cannot capture it, and that's why it is called spiritual, ethereal. So it is not related to the religious concept of spiritual, rather its character of being immaterial, volatile, unstable in its authority, and so it is called spirit like or spiritual. Is spiritual word ko agar aap mythology se relate karoge, then what we called in mythology regarding ruh, ye jo spiritual word hai, ye Arabic word ruh se bhi correlate kiya gaya hai. So it is somehow like that, spirit like. Hahnemann yahan pe usko direct pran aur atma se nahi mila raha hai, बट उसकी तरह कह रहा है. सो दिस इज कॉल्ड वन कैरेक्टर ऑफ वाइटल फोर्स इज कॉल्ड स्पिरिचुअल. अनदर कैरेक्टर ऑफ वाइटल फोर्स इज ऑटोक्रेसी. ऑटो मींस सेल्फ, क्रेसी मींस गवर्न्ड, रूल्ड. सो अपने आप से चलने वाला, अपने आप को गवर्न करने वाला, अपने आप को वर्क करने वाला, अपने आप को डायरेक्ट करने वाला, द सेल्फ गवर्न्ड बॉडी. So it is not under influence of something else. When it is in a healthy state, rather it will work on its own way. That is called autocracy. The dynamis. इस डायनामिक्स को हम लोग बहुत अच्छे से डिस्क्राइब करेंगे व्हेन वी विल स्टडी एफरिज्म नंबर 11 एंड इट्स फुटनोट. आपके पास टेक्स्ट बुक है तो देख लेना, एफरिज्म नंबर 11 के सेकंड फुटनोट में बहुत अच्छे से हनीमन ने इसको डिस्क्राइब किया है. सो वी विल स्टडी इट इन मोर डिटेल्स द वर्ड डायनामिक. डायनामिक को समझ लेना, इट इज सच ए टाइप ऑफ कैरेक्टर ऑफ फोर्स that is called a conceptual force that we cannot see, we cannot touch, we cannot connect, but again it is the presence of that. Dynamic is called immaterial. It is opposite of being immaterial. It is being opposite of being static. It is not a static, that is vital force. Ek jagah usko isolate karke nahi rakh sakte. That's why it is called dynamic. Jab bhi hai, apne gardish mein hai. जब तक अपने गर्दिश में है तो है, नहीं है तो नहीं है. उसको आप स्टैटिक, इसको आइसोलेट, इसको आप क्वांटमाइज्ड करके नहीं रख सकते. नेक्स्ट इज कॉल्ड ऑटोमेटिक. दैट मींस इट रिएक्ट्स इटसेल्फ. इसको रिएक्ट करने के लिए किसी गाइडेंस, किसी इंफॉर्मेशन, किसी एक ऑर्डर की जरूरत नहीं है. इट रिएक्ट्स टू इटसेल्फ ऑटोमेटिक. जहां इसके ऊपर कुछ आएगा, इट विल रिस्पॉन्ड इट ऑटोमेटिकली. दैट्स व्हाई इट इज कॉल्ड ऑटोमेटिक. And now immaterial. This is what is important, because it is immaterial. And that's why we cannot see it, we cannot touch it, we cannot taste it. And another very important differentiation, that this vital force, we should not mix it with the force that we study in our physics, that we have already studied in our physics. Because whatever we have studied in physics, it is regarding materialism. It is regarding physical world. Here we are studying in biological world. So here the vital force is not defined in the definitions as in your physics. ठीक है, so इस vital force को आप force mass into acceleration add करने मत लग जाना कि किसके अंदर कितना न्यूटन force है और कितना energy है. It is not a physical matter. It is regarding the biological world, and we have two distinct world in our science. One is called physical world and one is called biological world. Whatever we are studying here in relation to is biological world. So every world of physics is not going to apply here. And so this force we should not study in relation to the physical world. इसको थोड़ा सा और आपको हम डिस्क्राइब करेंगे जब एफरिज्म नंबर 10 आपको बताएंगे. व्हेन हनीमैन यूज द वर्ड प्रिंसिपल इन रिप्लेस ऑफ द वर्ड फोर्स, देन आई विल डिस्क्राइब यू समथिंग मोर. आई थिंक वी हैव 2 मिनट्स मोर जस्ट टू डिस्कस. इफ एनीवन हैविंग एनी डाउट, देन यू कैन आस्क मी इन योर ग्रुप और एल्सवेयर, देन आई विल रिप्लाई यू in the next class. 1 minute more is left. If anyone wants to ask something regarding this aphorism,
sir, dynamis ka ek bar explain kar diye.
Dynamis ko abhi bataya beta, aphorism number 11 jab explain karenge to aur detail mein explain karenge, because abhi jitna time hai isme hoga nahi. Theek hai,
okay sir. Okay sir.
Okay, so okay, thank stay you, healthy sir. Then we will meet, I think, tomorrow at the same time. Okay, till now,
thank you,
healthy.
Sir.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Family.